Hi everyone, Anthony Fantano here, internet's busiest music nerd, and it's time for a review of the new Marqué Hill record, Modern Flows, Volume 2. Marqué Hill is a trumpet player, a band leader, and a composer out of Chicago who's been dropping one record after the next for the good part of this decade now. His brand of jazz fits into a pretty wide range from old school modal stuff to more modern fusions with hip-hop and soul and R&B and pop. That is still the case on his latest full-length record over here, which is a pretty beefy follow-up to the Modern Flows EP that dropped several years ago. Maybe it's also his beefiest record yet in general, standing at 15 tracks and over an hour of material. The personnel on this record is as follows. Of course, you have Marqué Hill on trumpet, Josh Johnson on alto saxophone, Joel Ross on vibraphone, Junius Paul on bass, and Jonathan Pinson on the drums. Also throughout the record are a handful of different guest vocalists and rappers that are peppered throughout the tracks. Only a handful of moments, though. The majority of this album is straight jazz performances. I don't want to hear anybody complaining about, oh, I don't like raps all over my jazz. Though pretty much all the verses on this record are wonderfully and cleverly abstract or socially conscious, and the jazz rap backdrops the band provides are pretty funky and enjoyable. Contrast moments like this with a track like Kiss and Tell, which features a lovey-dovey duet between Braxton Cook and Rachel Robinson right in the middle of the record. Overall, the band has a pretty versatile sound between the guest vocalists, the solo abilities of each individual member, the horn harmonies, the serene vibraphone chords, the dynamic and very busy drums, the nimble bass, a few spoken word passages. Add on to that the number of tracks the band is hitting listeners with on this record and all the genres they're bringing into the fold. Pretty routinely throughout this record, the band presents one fun, flashy idea after another or a different direction with a very clean, modern sound and tight, brisk performances. There are some cuts on this record that frankly come off pretty serene, meditative, low-key. Prayer for the People featuring Emerald Green is certainly an example. Not only on this track does she give this really compelling spoken word piece on gentrification, black families essentially being priced out of their own neighborhoods, but the track eventually evolves into these grand, weepy horn harmonies and some wonderfully smooth drum and bass grooves. There are also some points where you get kind of like these overlapping vibes and trumpet leads that are absolutely gorgeous. The band turns up the heat on a few cuts here, especially on Moments of Flow, which has one of the most unique grooves I've heard on a modern jazz song in a while, especially considering how the bass plays off of the drums on this track. Hill and his band present equally unique grooves on the intro to As I Am, on the Cut the Watcher, and even though a lot of the performances and the solos on this thing can hit hard, especially the vibraphone solos. They are dizzying on this record. But, I wouldn't necessarily say there's anything about the performances on Modern Flows that feels overly aggressive or anything like that. The punchiest this album gets is really on the more jazz rap influence cuts where the bass and the drums are really kind of turned up. For the most part, what defines Hill and his band's performances on this record is this really subtle presentation of incredibly complex and intricate interplay between each musician on this record. Because the band plays so frickin' well, they have this knack for hitting the listener with an onslaught of impressive solos and embellishments, some of which just coincide, especially with Jonathan Pinson. Whenever there's an intense moment where the horns or the vibes are building or just going absolutely wild, he is not shy about kind of just going through some insane drum fills. But throughout the moments of very nuanced and subtle chaos on this record, the band always seems very tight. It always comes together really well. And while I'm talking about the track The Watcher, I do want to say I love how the song musically transitions into the next cut, which is more of a jazz rap song, and that track essentially thrives off of a music loop from The Watcher, so it's almost like a bit of a musical genre transition, an epilogue of sorts. And that's one of many kind of tiny, subtle moments throughout this record where the songs on this thing kind of link together very nicely. The flow of this record overall is pretty great, especially in the first half. There are also a lot of very nice instrumental and aesthetic threads that run through a lot of these cuts, so even though it is a long album, it all feels very cohesive. As far as other highlights on this record go, I do love the track Ego versus Spirit, which after the way the difference between the two is explained on the back end of the song, it makes the contrast of more beautiful and kind of laid back passages on this cut, which kind of mix with the more intense solo passages, which are a lot darker and maybe a bit more sinister. It kind of makes the dichotomy between those two sounds much more apparent, and almost feels like I'm listening to a bit of a musical yin and yang. I also love some of the more deconstructed music passages on the track As I Am Too. And I mean, even though there are highlights that I can pick up throughout the entire album, I will say I do think the second half isn't quite as thrilling as the first. To go back to the Cook and Robinson duet on the record, I find their vocal performances to be a bit more theatrical than they are legitimately passionate or fiery or exciting, as talented vocally as they seem to be. Meanwhile, there are a handful of other cuts like Smoke Break and It's All Beautiful, and even the song Stellar to an extent, which to me just feel like overly smooth filler. I mean, the tracks are very easygoing, they're pleasant, they're pretty, but there's nothing particular about their performance or their progression or composition or even the solos on the track that are really all that gripping. They just really kind of feel like wallpaper in comparison to a lot of what else is here. While I do admire the band's attempts to kind of break up the flow of this record with some more easygoing cuts, these songs are just missing anything exciting or interesting for me. And I do have a slight gripe with the mix and the sound of the record in some spots, because I do wish the bass and the drums had a bit more body and space and presence. There are quite a few songs here where I feel like they come off a bit too dry and flat, like they don't have enough oomph in the mix. I mean, granted, on the more hip-hop led cuts, they do feel quite beefy, but on some of the more jazz-oriented numbers, they just don't really have that much push in comparison with the vibes in the horns. Though that's most likely the rock and hip-hop fan in me talking, and also I do sort of acknowledge that there is kind of a difficulty there with how these different genres respectively are mixed, especially jazz and rap, and yet you have an artist over here who's trying to bring the two together effectively, and for the most part, I think he does. All that being said, though, I think this is a really great and dynamic, fun, colorful, and incredibly well-executed jazz record, with a lot of flavor, a lot of variety, clean sound, great performances, and certainly a very modern edge to it too. I'm feeling a strong 7 to a light 8 on this thing. Tran. Zishan, have you given this album a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well. Over here next to my head is another video that you can check out. Hit that up or the link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, Marky Hill, Modern Flows, forever.